We dream of a Christianity that looks like Jesus again. We read the words of the gospel and Jesus's, you know, the things that he said in those red letters, and we say, what if he really meant this stuff? What if we were to live our lives based on the words of Jesus?
Two things. Number one is this is an intergenerational conversation. I'm an old guy, he's a young guy, and we're coming at controversial subjects from different generations, but using the same Bible. And I think the thing that amazed me is we use the Bible as our source, that whether you're young or whether you're old, the Bible pretty much says the same thing. It was Gandhi who once declared that everybody knows what Jesus taught, except for Christians. In a real sense, I think the church has been running away from the hard sayings of Christ. I think it was Chesterton, the guy that inspired so much of C.S. Lewis, who said it's not that Christianity has been tried and failed. It's that it's not been tried. And then in another place he said, it's been tried, but it's been found too difficult. We have not avoided the difficulty of what it means to be a Christian. And yet, I think what Shane brings to this book, which is so powerful, is that the sacrifices that are made do not lead us into a boring, humdrum, dull lifestyle. There's celebration, there's joy. I come away from talking with Shane and writing this book with a sense, why would anybody want to live any differently than the ways in which Jesus calls us to live in his radical words?